My dear students, welcome you all in the third year of your diploma. I, Mr. Aniket Patil, will teach you power engineering and refrigeration subject for this semester. This subject has three lectures in a week and one practical of 2 hours. It has 5 credits and end sem examination, that is your MSBT exam, will be taken of 70 marks and it has a progressive assessment of 30 marks, which consists 20 marks of 2 unit test, it is average, and 10 marks for your micro project. It also has a practical end semester exam of 25 marks and a progressive assessment, that is your manual, of 25 marks. It totally consists of 150 marks. We'll look practicals. The first and second practical are part 1 and part 2 of assembly and dismantling of single cylinder IC engine. It requires 4 hours for these two practicals. The third and fourth practical are again part 1 and part 2 of assembly and dismantling of multi-cylinder IC engine that are used on all your four wheelers. The fifth experiment is assembly and dismantling of rotary fuel pump in a diesel engine. Sixth practical is trial on IC engine to prepare heat balance sheet and plot performance characteristics, part 1, and the second one is a part 2. Eighth practical is trial on IC engine to perform Morse test. Ninth practical is measurement of IC engine pollutants using exhaust gas analyzer. 10th is a trial on two-stage reciprocating air compressor to find volumetric efficiency, that is part 1, and second one. 11th is a part 2. 12th is a demonstration on gas turbine model. 13th, vapor compression cycle, part 1, and 14th, part 2. 15th, assembly and dismantling of domestic refrigerator, and 16th, use of refrigeration and air conditioning tools in a maintenance of these units. We have to conduct minimum 12 practicals from all these 16, and those practicals who have shown by star mark are compulsory practicals. While doing analysis of your practical, it is divided in the 5 parts. 20% marks are given for the hands-on skill. 20% marks are given for reading different instruments. 30% marks are given for calculating performance parameters. 20% marks are given for sample questions. And 10% marks are given for submitting the report in a given time. Again, when you will attend the college, you have to perform this in the laboratories. While doing the same, you have to follow some of the instructions, that are, you have to follow the safety practices. You have to practice good housekeeping, or demonstrate working as a leader or team leader. You have to maintain tools and equipments and follow the ethical practices. These are some of the major equipments that you will use while conducting practicals. Now, we will come towards the theory content. Your first unit is an internal combustion engines, that is IC engines. The first point is power cycles, engine terminology, working of four stroke engines, Carnot cycle, Otto cycle, diesel cycle, dual cycle, and some numericals on the same. Actual indicator diagrams for four stroke engines. And second point is IC engine auxiliaries, that are fall timing diagrams, VVTI engines that are variable valve timing, concept and arrangement, supercharging, its objectives and advantages, turbocharging, MPFI layout and sensors, that is multipoint fuel injection system, inline fuel injection pumps, piezoelectric injectors and exhaust gas recirculation, that is EGR layout. The third point is combustion in SI engines, pre-ignition, detonation, concept, factors affecting detonation and HUCR. Your second unit is testing of IC engines and emission control. Now, whenever you manufacture an engine, you have to test the different parameters for its actual working. The first point in this unit is IC engine testing parameters, that are indicated power, BSFC, components of heat balance sheet, thermal and mechanical efficiency, Morse test. Second point is exhaust emissions and control. Polluting emission in IC engines, effect on environment, measurement of exhaust emissions, effect of air fuel ratio on exhaust emission with graph, Euro 4 and Euro 6 norms for M and N1 vehicles, catalytic converter and SCR. The second point is most important when we consider the today's scenario of pollution because of the vehicles or IC engines. Third unit is air compressors. In that, the first point is reciprocating compressors, its applications, working of single stage and two stage compressors with PV diagrams and intercooling. Second point is testing of reciprocating air compressor, pressure ratio, compressor capacity, free air delivery, volumetric efficiency, isothermal efficiency, numerical methods of energy saving. The third point is rotary compressors, screw compressor, centrifugal compressor, vent type compressor, comparison of rotary with reciprocating. The fourth unit is gas turbines and jet propulsion. In that, the first point is types of gas turbines, constant pressure, open cycle and closed cycle gas turbines, Breton cycle and its applications. Second point is jet propulsion, turbojet, turboprop engines. Third point is rocket propulsion, liquid and solid propellant systems. The fifth unit is refrigeration and air conditioning. In that, the first point is refrigeration, unit of refrigeration, Carnot cycle, vapor compression cycle, subcooling and superheating, refrigerant properties, concept of GWP and ODP. Second point is applications, domestic refrigerator, water cooler, ice plant and cold storage. Third point is air conditioning, its definition and classification. Fourth point is psychometry, properties of air, psychometric processes, psychometric chart. Fifth point is applications, window air conditioning, split air conditioners and central air conditioning. First unit has total 10 lectures or teaching hours. Second unit has 10 lectures. Third unit has 10 lectures. Fourth unit will take 6 lectures. Fifth unit will take 10 lectures. Again, for MSBT, the first unit will be asked for 16 marks. Second unit will be asked for 16 marks. Third for 14 marks. Fourth for 8 marks. And the last one will be asked for 16 marks, and it comes to the total 70 marks. Some of the suggested student activities are: prepare a PowerPoint presentation on emission norms, make charts for performance characteristics of IC engine, make a chart showing heat balance sheet format to display in laboratory, collect specifications of gas turbine based engines used for power generation and for jet engines, collect specifications of domestic refrigerators and window air conditioners from manufacturer's website, collect information on different tests actually used for IC engines, measure DBT and WBT using thermometer and calculate rest of the properties of air using psychometric chart. Prepare troubleshooting chart for domestic refrigerator, window air conditioner. Prepare electrical troubleshooting chart for refrigeration system. Prepare troubleshooting chart for IC engine. Prepare seminar report on dual fuel and hybrid engines. Visit an industry where air compressors are monitored online using SCADA or similar system and write a report on the same. Then we'll see the suggested micro projects. The first micro project is to display various components of MPFI system on wooden board with labels. Second one is to prepare a report on OBD measurements. Third is take a sample of cooling load calculation sheet. List the components of cooling load along with percentage contribution of different loads in a refrigeration or air conditioning. Fourth, display various parts of hermetically sealed open compressor or wooden board with labels. Fifth, collect and display different gaskets required for a single cylinder or multi-cylinder IC engine. Prepare report on different types of lubricating oils, oil filters, coolants for petrol engines with respect to physical and chemical properties, cost, safety and disposal, etc. Make a working model of air compressor. Prepare a step-by-step procedure for dismantling and assembly of a multi-cylinder IC engine. Tabulate different tools used in dismantling of IC engine against components for which these tools are used. Some of the suggested reference books are Internal Combustion Engine by M.I. Mathur and R.P. Sharma from Dhanpat Rai Publications, Thermal Engineering by R.K. Rajput from Lakshmi Publications, Refrigeration and Air Conditioning by R.S. Kurmi and J.K. Gupta from S. Chand Publication. The 14th point shows some of the websites that you can refer while studying this subject.